அன்பார்ந்த மாணவர்களே, இந்த வீடியோவில் 12ஆம் வகுப்பிற்குரிய கெமிஸ்ட்ரி யூனிட் 11 ஹைட்ராக்சி காம்பவுண்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் ஈதேஸ் என்ற பாடத்தில் ப்ரிப்பரேஷன் ஆஃப் ஈதேஸ் அண்ட் பிசிக்கல் ப்ராப்பர்டீஸ் என்ற பகுதியை பார்க்க உள்ளோம். முதல் ப்ரிப்பரேஷன் ஆஃப் ஈதேஸ். First method, intermolecular dehydration of alcohols. Already in this chapter, we studied when alcohols are heated with the concentrated sulfuric acid at 443 Kelvin, intramolecular dehydration takes place to form alkene, that is elimination reaction. Okay, intramolecular dehydration. But here the temperature is slightly different, slightly less. Okay, here you see 443 Kelvin. Now the temperature is 413 Kelvin. Now the product obtained is ethers are formed. And the dehydration type is intermolecular dehydration. Okay, you see here this is one ethanol molecule, this is one ethanol, this is another ethanol molecule. Heated with the concentrated sulfuric acid at about 413 Kelvin temperature. Now, from one alcohol OH and another alcohol H combined to form water, remaining part will join. So we'll get CH3, CH2O, CH2, CH3, this product plus water. Then mechanism of this reaction. Before that, you see this method is useful for the preparation of simple ether. You see this side, ethyl, here also ethyl. Simple ether. If you use two different kinds of alcohol, we may get mixed ether also. But it is not possible to separate the products. It is not possible, means the separation is very difficult. Very difficult to separate the products. For example, you see, if you use here methanol, CH3OH, another alcohol, say ethanol, then what will be the product you will get? Two methanol molecule may join to form CH3OCH3, dimethyl ether. Two ethanol will join to form like this ether, diethyl ether. One side methanol, another side ethanol may combine. In this case, we will get ethyl methyl ether. So three kinds of ethers are possible to obtain. Then it is very difficult to separate the three products. Okay, that's why this method is used for the preparation of simple ethers. Okay, mechanism. This method is useful for the preparation of simple ethers and not suitable for the preparation of mixed ethers. If mixer of two different alcohol is used, mixer of different ethers will be formed and they are difficult to separate. Okay, this is not mechanism. Next part is the mechanism. This is the mechanism. Okay. Now you see here, one alcohol is taken, concentrated sulfuric acid. So, this concentrated sulfuric acid protonate the alcohol to form oxonium ion. Okay, this you see, the alcohol have two lone pair electron. It donate a lone pair electron to H plus of acid to form OH bond. Since oxygen lost the electron, it becomes a positive charge. Okay, at the same time here you see, this OH bond is cleaved, the electron pair goes to the oxygen. So this part becomes HSO4 minus. Okay. Then another molecule of alcohol. You see, now what will happen? You see, this is CO bond is cleaved and the electron pair goes to oxygen. So oxygen becomes neutral. We will get water molecule. Now we will get water molecule. Now since this carbon lost the electron, it becomes a positive. Immediately, another alcohol donate electron pair to this carbon to make a bond. So we'll get like this product. You see, CH3, CH2. This oxygen, this hydrogen here. Okay, here then this one CH2, CH3. Okay, in this case, you see the oxygen lost the electron, so it becomes a fast charge. Okay, then next step, what will happen? You see, this OH bond is cleaved and the electron pair goes to oxygen. So the oxygen becomes neutral now, hydrogen becomes a positive charge. Okay, so from water, oxygen donate electron pair to this hydrogen and make a bond to form hydronium ion, H3O plus, hydronium ion is formed. Okay, the next one is Williamson-Ether synthesis. Okay, Williamson-Ether synthesis. When an alkyl halide is heated with an alcoholic solution of sodium alkoxide, the corresponding ethers are obtained. The reaction involves SN2 mechanism. Okay, you see here sodium ethoxide and ethyl bromide. We use here, this is sodium and bromine combined to form NaBr, remaining part is joined. Okay, so we'll get CH3O, CH2CH3, or we can say C2H5. C2H5 is same as CH2CH3. Okay, and then plus NaBr. Then mechanism of this reaction, sodium ethoxide, it is ionic compound, so CH3O minus and O in a Na plus. Okay, then ethyl bromide. Now what will happen? You see, the CBr bond is cleaved and the electron pair goes to bromine, so we'll get Br minus. This Br minus combined with the Na plus to form NaBr. Okay, so this carbon becomes now positive charge. This oxygen is negative. Oxygen donate electron pair to this carbon to make a bond. So we'll get, you see, CH2. This O and this CH3. Okay, this oxygen becomes neutral now. Okay, we know that primary alkyl halide are more susceptible for SN2 reaction. Okay, hence for the preparation of mixed ether having primary and tertiary alkyl group, two groups are there, one is primary, another is tertiary. In such a case, the primary alkyl halide and tertiary alkoxide we have to use. Okay, otherwise we won't get the corresponding product, some other product we will get. Okay, on the other hand, if we use tertiary alkyl halide and primary alkoxide, elimination dominates and succeeds over substitution to form an alkene. So if you use tertiary alkyl halide and primary alkoxide, then we will get alkene instead of getting ether. Okay, you see, this is tertiary sodium alkoxide and primary alkyl halide. Here we will get ether. Yes, right. So now the reaction, you see, the CBr bond is cleaved and this electron pair goes to the bromine. So this bromine becomes bromide ion Br minus. So this Br minus combined with the Na plus to form NaBr. So now you see this oxygen having negative charge. It gives electron to this carbon to make a bond. So we will get this compound. Okay. 2-methyl-2-methoxypropane. 2-methyl-2-methoxypropane. Okay. That is 1, 2, 3. 2. Methyl is there. So 2-methyl. Okay. At the position number 2, methoxy group is there. Okay. Then if instead of this one, just reverse if you use, you see what will happen. That means tertiary alkyl halide and primary sodium alkoxide. Now what will happen, you see? this CH3, one hydrogen is shown here separately. Okay. Now what will happen? You see, the CH bond is cleaved and the electron pair goes to this place. Okay, then the CBr bond is cleaved and this bromine leaves out as Br minus, bromide ion. So here double bond is formed now. Okay, this Br minus combined with the Na plus to form NaBr. Here this H plus, you see here, then O minus is there. This O minus gives the electron to this H plus and make a bond. So we'll get the CH3OH. Like this compounds will get. Okay. This is alkene. 2-methyl-prop-1-ene. Then methylation of alcohol. Methyl ethers can be, what is called methyl ether? So you see, one side of oxygen methyl group is there, then the compound is called methyl ether. Okay, any one side. Then methyl ethers can be prepared by treating an alcohol with diazomethane in the presence of catalyst. Which one? Fluoroboric acid. We can use hydrofluoroboric acid. We can use. Okay. So you see here ethanol. Then this compound is diazomethane. Diazo. Di means two. Azo means nitrogen. Diazomethane. From methane. Methane molecular formula is CH4. Instead of two hydrogen, two nitrogen is added. This compound is called diazomethane. So now what will happen? You see this N2 is removed. The remaining part will join here. CH will join with hydrogen to form CH3. So we will get the compound like this: CH3, CH2O, CH3 plus N2. Okay. So preparation is over. Then evaluate yourself. Which of the following reaction will give 1-methoxy-4-nitrobenzene? Here two options are given. So you see, this is the compound product we have to get. Okay, 1-methoxy-4-nitrobenzene. This compound we have to get. Two options are given. One is this one. You see, 4-nitro-1-bromo-benzene. This compound plus sodium ethoxide. If these two reacted, we will get this product. Okay, you see, this Na combined with the Br to form NaBr. So this OCH3 join here. We will get this product. Is right. Then second option, you see, this one, 4-nitro-sodium-phenoxide. 4-nitro-sodium-phenoxide. This compound. Okay. Plus bromomethane. Bromomethane. Here you see, if this Na and Br combine to form NaBr, so the CH3 will join here. We will get the same compound. This compound we will get again. Okay. So now, which option is correct? Which reaction is possible or easier? This reaction or this reaction? Which one is easier? In this case, you see, this bromine is directly attached to the benzene nucleus. So this CBr bond is very short and strong. So it is not possible to cleave this CBr bond. This bond is not so easy to cleave. So this reaction is not possible. If this bond is cleaved, then only this bromine will come in with the sodium. So this reaction is not possible. Okay. In this case, you see, the sodium combined with the bromine to form NaBr. So this CH3 will join here. So there is no need of cleavage of the CO bond. Okay. So this reaction is possible. Okay. So this is the correct choice. Then second question, you see, arrange the following compounds in the increasing order of their acid strength. So first we can write the weakest acid. Okay. You see, here propane 1-all. Already we studied alcohols are poor acidic or weakly acidic than phenols. Remaining all compounds are phenols only. So this is the least acidic. Okay. Then you see 2,4,6 trinitrophenol, 3-nitrophenol, 3,5-dinitrophenol, phenol. Okay. And 4-methylphenol. All are related to aromatic only, the phenols only. Okay. You see, already we studied if methyl group or plus I group attached to benzene ring, the acidic character will decrease. You have 4-methylphenol. So this methyl is having plus I effect. So having lower acidity. So next, second option is which one? 4-methylphenol. Then remaining, you see, all are nitrophenols. If nitro group is having minus I effect, so it increases the acidic character. Okay. Then you see, in this compound, 2,4,6 trinitrophenol. Three nitro groups are attached to ortho position and para position. So this is the highest acidic. Okay. Here one nitro group is there. Here two nitro group is there. This at which position? Meta position 3. Position number 3. It is meta. This is 3 and 5. Both are meta position only. Okay. So then higher acidic is 3-nitrophenol. Since here only one nitro group is there. Okay. You see 3-nitrophenol. Then 3,5-dinitrophenol. a 2 nitro group is there. So it is more acidic. Okay, the maximum acidity is this compound. So this is the order. Okay, then physical properties. Ethers are polar in nature. The dipole moment of ether is polar in nature. How is it? You see, ether is polar in nature. This is ether. You see, one oxygen, two alkyl or aryl groups are there. Okay, the alkyl groups have plus I effect. Plus I effect. So the bond pair shifted slightly towards the oxygen. Okay, and now the alkyl part, this side becomes delta positive, delta partial positive charge. This oxygen, this part becomes partial negative charge. Okay, then the oxygen have two lone pair electron also. So this side electron density is higher. So this molecule is polar. Ethers are polar in nature. The dipole moment of ether is the vector sum of two polar CO bonds. Okay, two polar CO bond, alkyl oxygen bonds, with a significant contribution from two lone pairs of electrons. For example, the dipole moment of diethyl ether is 1.18 d diopter. Boiling point of ethers are slightly higher than that of alkanes and lower than that of alcohols are comparable masses. Comparable masses mean comparable molecular masses. You see, for comparison, N-heptane, 1-methoxypentane, hexanol, three compounds are given. You see, this compound, molecular mass is, or molar mass is 100.21. This is 102.17. This is 102.16. Their boiling point you compare, this is alkane. Boiling point is lowest 371 Kelvin. This one come out, you see, either here 371, 373. Slight difference only. Slightly increases. Alkyl, you see, it is very much higher. Very much higher. Okay. Then oxygen of ether can also form hydrogen bond with water. Ether oxygen is able to form. This is ether. It is able to form hydrogen bond with water. This is water. With water, it is forming hydrogen bond. This is also. Okay. And hence, they are miscible with water. Miscible means soluble. Soluble with water. Ethers dissolve wide range of polar and non-polar substances. So, ether is a best solvent. Okay. Even polar as well as non-polar substances dissolves in ether, which one ether. Okay. So, ether is a best solvent. அன்பார்ந்த மாணவர்களே, இந்த வீடியோ உங்களுக்கு பிடித்திருந்தால் சப்ஸ்கிரைப் செய்யுங்கள், லைக் செய்யுங்கள், ஷேர் செய்யுங்கள். திரையில் தோன்றும் லிங்கை பயன்படுத்தி பிளஸ் டூ கெமிஸ்ட்ரியில் உள்ள வீடியோக்கள் அனைத்தையும் பார்வையிடலாம். நன்றி.